party leader, Honorable John Briceño, members of the PUP executive, all members of Team 31 of the PUP, my fellow Belizeans, members and supporters of the People's United Party. You know, after listening to Francis just now, I don't really think I need to say anything more, because he got already pumped up to do. Because, as he pointed out, that man said, you the people tired, I got nothing. When you tired, I got nothing. That time when you get something. And you'll get that something with the People's United Party. My friends, 30 years ago, let us remember, it was the People's United Party under George Price that led this country, led all of us, the Belizean people, to political independence. 30 years ago, Belize became a nation state. 30 years ago, we had an independent constitution which guaranteed us freedom, justice, and equality of opportunity for all the people. And most importantly, 30 years ago, with the People's United Party, Belize became a country governed with democracy under the rule of law. Now, why am I talking about law today? I am talking about law today not only because I'm a lawyer, not the way I practice law, right? Because my successor, John Briceño, will lead this party to victory, our next Prime Minister. My friends, the promise of our democracy was to bring about development with an economy that served the common good of all the people. 3.5 years later, under Dean Barrow and the UDP, Belize, my friends, we all know this, our country is in crisis. We are suffering from what I would call economic depression under Barrow and political repression under Barrow. Economic depression, political repression. In other words, when people down, they down there already. The cost of living down gone sky high, unbearable for most of the people. Unemployment is at 24%. Poverty is growing over 40%. So the people are down already, economic depression. They can't pay the school bill for the children. People can't pay their light bill and water bill. People can't pay their rent. People are suffering under this UDP government like never before. And with this economic depression, my friends, we look around us, we see what is happening. Business shutting down. The biggest shrimp farm in our country shut down. Hundreds of people out of work from the south. And then we have this thing, as Michael Spott was saying, the marketing board can't manage the industries that we have that they put in their hands. Look how they can't even pay on time the rice farmers in Toledo, and how they cheated the poor onion farmers in the north. Where they lose $1 million, the onions rotting in the field because of corruption of this UDP government. That is right. So my friends, we have this economic depression. On top of it now, we have the Barrow political repression. Squeezing the people, taking away your freedom. The freedom that you fought for to win political independence, under a democratic constitution. Today, no land for the landless, no home for the homeless. The thousands of people who were promised that they will get their house, they will get their land, they will get free education. Those people have been betrayed by Dean Barrow and the UDP. Instead of freedom, my friends, instead of showing some love for the people, instead of creating, building homes for the people, we see what they did a few weeks ago in Belize City. They drove mothers and children out of their homes, put them on the street at 4 o'clock in the morning. That is the kind of government we have. That is the political repression we have in Belize today. And now, as the song was reminding us, we have this GSU. GSU, Gang Suppression Unit, which is treating all of us like one big gang because they are suppressing all of us. That's what the GSU is doing. We are all a gang now. We the people, the majority, are the gangs that Dean Barrow is suppressing with the GSU. They're breaking into people's homes, destroying people's property. They go in the dead of night and knock down your door, treat everybody like criminals. My friends, how can the UDP control crime in Belize when the biggest criminals are right there in Belmopan? You know, the truth of the matter is, my friends, what we're dealing with here is a bully. We have a Prime Minister who is a nasty bully. A nasty bully. You see how he tried to treat me in the house? Call me all kind of thing. He think he could frighten me. He think he could intimidate me. But I can tell her, don't watch me, watch yourself. You're going down, Barrow. You're going down. He's a lying, nepotistic dictator. That's what he is. And the people have had enough. The people want PUP under John Briseño. They want John Briseño to be the next Prime Minister of Belize. How can we tolerate a government, this UDP government, that wants now to introduce preventive detention to lock you up, even though you've done nothing wrong, to lock you up on just suspicion? And they want to lock you up for 52 days. 52 days they will lock you up. No charge. You have no right to speak to a lawyer. You have children have no right to speak to their parents. What kind of thing is happening to our country? How can we tolerate this? I say enough is enough. We're not going to stand for it. No to preventative detention. You see how they went to the house last week and passed those laws suddenly without giving notice properly even to the opposition party. I got my notice late Friday night when we were at a convention. And they passed a very important law, my friends, that will have very serious repercussions, taking away our constitutional democratic right. And that is, they abolish the jury system for serious crimes in our country, like murder. Now, my friends, you might think, well, that only one hurt the one that will commit murder. Not so. Not so. The principle is that anybody charged with a serious crime is entitled to be judged by his own equals, by his peers, by his own people. That is our system of justice. It goes back hundreds of years, and Dean Barrow, by the stroke of a pen, took it away last week. That's right, they took away that jury trial. My friends, we must be awake to what is happening in our country. You see, this is how it all started. You study history, you will realize that this is how it all started in Nazi Germany under Adolf Hitler. First they controlled the courts, then they controlled the media, then they controlled the people with false propaganda. Then they controlled the entire economy, and then they controlled all of us. This is what is happening under Dean Barrow and the UDP. Like we heard it today, they talk a good talk. They talk about nationalization. Well, my friends, it is no nationalization when you take away BTL in order to sell it to another company, another foreign company at that. Because you remember he was talking about bringing in the latest one, bringing in some people from Argentina to buy BTL as the strategic partners. That is not true nationalization. Well, the Court of Appeal found them out. The Court of Appeal last week struck down Dean Barrow and the UDP and their nationalization of BTL. Now watch me, Barrow. Watch yourself. But what has happened also shows us something else. Even though the Court of Appeal has ruled that the Barrow takeover of BTL was unconstitutional, in other words, illegal, void of no effect, in other words, the company has to go back to the original owners, even though the court ruled, Mr. Dean Barrow get on the TV one evening and said he will respect the court decision. 6 hours later, in the dead of night, he sent the police and the BDF to take back control of BTL. Now, what kind of respect for law and order is that? What kind of respect for the rule of law is that? That is why, my friends, I told you, I have to talk about law today, because this man believes he is above the law. Dean Barrow believes he is above the law. Well, John Bisseño and the POP will show him that he has to come under the law. Under the law. You know, my friends, with all this chaos, confusion, crisis that we're living in, I say to you today, it did not have to be like that. It did not have to be like that. When the UDP took over in February of 2008, the POP left in the coffers of this country over $100 million. The POP had reduced the fiscal deficit to less than 1%. When you see what is happening to countries all around the world today, in Greece and Ireland, Portugal, Spain, all these countries facing serious problems, POP left this country with less than 1% fiscal deficit. And then they like talk about the super bond. Sorry, party leader and members, colleagues that are going on about this, but I think it's important that we talk a little bit today about this false propaganda of the UDP. They talk that they can't do better because of the super bond. Well, my friends, let me tell you, the PUP and Mark Espato was right there involved in helping us to get that super bond solved. That's right. The PUP went all around this world meeting with the creditors, and we successfully restructured the debt of this country to such an extent that the so-called super bond gives this government, Barrow, 22 years. Not 1 or 2 years, you know. 22 years to start paying down on the debt. 22 years. That are more than 3-4 government down the road, no? 22 years to pay down the debt with interest rate at between 4 and 8%. In other words, the super bond played right into their hands. We set the table for them. And if they were a good government, if they had continued with the growth and development that the PUP had started, we would not be in this position today. But instead, they want to take everything for themselves. They want to fire you, PUP, and put in their cronies, UDP. That's what they've been doing. And Barrow wants to put control of all these companies in the hands of his own family. That is what we call nepotism. Well, my friends, enough. Enough of this corruption. Enough of it. The time will move forward now. The man with the shout just now. El cambio es necesario. It's time for the change. It is time for the change. And the change is coming with John Briseño and the People's United Party. Adelante! Adelante, compañeros. Let us go forward. Thank you.